Blackstone presents Hunters of the Lost City by Callie Wallace. This book is read by Sophie Amoss. For every girl who wants to change the world. 1. The Bells of Vittoria. Every morning, as the first light of the sun shone over the mountains, bells rang from the 7 watchtowers of Vittoria. Octavia kicked her thick blankets down, jumped out of bed, and threw open the shutters. The morning was cold, and her breath misted as she leaned on the windowsill. The scents of fresh bread and warm pastries rose from her family's bakery below. The first bell to chime was atop the tallest tower, which overlooked Wyvern Gate on the northern side of town. It rang as soon as the sunlight touched the summits of the highest peaks surrounding the valley. Movement on the narrow street caught Octavia's eye. 4 stories down, a pair of town guards in black uniforms rushed down Fishing Cat Lane toward Juniper Street. She felt an uncomfortable twinge of worry in her chest. It wasn't normal for the guards to be rushing about this early, before the gates were even open. Something must have happened during the night. She didn't hear any shouts or sounds of alarm. She hoped it was nothing serious. The guards were gone from Fishing Cat Lane by the time the second bell began to ring. 5 more followed in quick succession, and soon all 7 bells were ringing together, all around the 7-pointed star of Vittoria's high wall. Their song chased up and down the River Nix and Long Road, echoed from the rocky mountainsides and the forested hills, and filled the terraced fields and orchards of the lonely vale. For the townspeople of Vittoria, the morning bells meant the day was about to begin. The bells meant it was time to wake, time to rise, time to work. During the daytime, it was safe to venture beyond the wall, and it would be safe until darkness fell again. Vittoria was the last town in the world, home to the only survivors of a terrible war, surrounded by a vast and dangerous wilderness. The worst of the dangers were the monsters, and for those monsters, the morning bells meant something else entirely. They were a warning, a signal to the creatures that lurked in the forest that daylight was coming. It was time for them to flee into the darkest thickets and caves, where they would cower until night came again. The creatures were called Ferrocks, a name given to them by the sorcerer who had created them as weapons of war, designed to attack with ruthless speed and vicious power under the cover of night. That sorcerer was gone now, and the war long over, but the Ferrocks remained. The endless rhythm of day and night, safety and danger, light and darkness, defined life in Vittoria. Octavia could feel the bright promise of the morning bells in her bones, just as she would later feel the ominous warning of the evening bells. The bells that rang at twilight had a deeper, heavier sound. Octavia listened until the bells fell quiet. The morning was cold, but the sky was clear and cloudless, streaked pink to the east, with the last stars twinkling in the west. Clear skies meant good light, good visibility, easier tracking. Today would be a perfect day for hunting. The small ferrocks that wandered close to Vittoria during the day were not truly dangerous, but they were good practice, and practice was what Octavia needed. Octavia dressed quickly in her trousers and shirt and 2 big leather boots. Across their shared attic bedroom, her brother Albus mumbled unintelligibly and rolled over in his bed. 2 cats, a fat ginger and a scrappy gray, slept on his feet. Albus would sleep as long as he could get away with, even if it meant being late to his apprenticeship at the knife maker's forge. Octavia pulled the shutters closed, grabbed her bag from its hook, and kicked the side of Albus's bed. "Wake up, stupid," Octavia said. "You're going to be late again." Albus answered with another grumble. The ginger cat glared disapprovingly. It'll be your own fault when Master Aoife replaces you. Octavia kicked the bed again. And she will. Aoife the knife maker did not tolerate laziness, but Albus didn't seem to care.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.